Good morning, everyone. Namaskar. Thank you to all the beautiful, lovely people who've joined us. It's a pleasure and delight once again for me, your host, Rumi Chaudhary, to be welcoming all of you to yet another educative, informative Vidyadan webinar, which is being brought to you under the aegis of MESC, the Media and Entertainment Skills Council. And today, ladies and gentlemen, is platform ke madhyam se, apne is Vidyadan webinar ke madhyam se, aaj hum ek aisa art, ek aisa craft, ek aisa profession, ek aisa career discuss karne ja rahe, explore karne ja rahe hain, which I feel is one of the most emotive, immersive, and yes, an entertaining career, and of course, a career which lets you explore so many facets. और ये एक ऐसा करियर है, एक ऐसा प्रोफेशन है जिसमें आपको अनेक किरदार निभाने का मौका मिलता है और जाने कितने जीवन जीने का मौका मिलता है. हर एक किरदार में आपको कितने रस, 11 रस जो हम कहते हैं, पहले 9 रस कहते थे, जो 11 रस आजकल कहते हैं, श्रृंगार रस हुआ या हास्य रस हुआ, वीर रस हुआ, करुणा रस, शांत रस, अद्भुत रस, वात्सल्य रस और भयानक रस, रौद्र रस, भक्ति रस, मेरे ख्याल से सारे 11 रस मैंने बोल दिए. तो ये सभी रस किसी ना किसी किरदार में आपको अपने जीवन काल में, अपने करियर में आपको ये जीने का, इमोट करने का, एक्सप्रेस करने का मौका मिलता है. ऐसा किसी भी करियर में देखने को नहीं मिलता. और जी हाँ, रील है पर रियल लगता है. एंड इफ आई कैन गो लिटिल फिलोसॉफिकल ऑल्सो अबाउट इट, आई फील इट इज एक्चुअली अ स्पिरिचुअल क्वेस्ट टू टच द ह्यूमन बींग्स. जैसे कि हम कल कह रहे थे कि ये एक तपस्या है. जितना ज़्यादा आप गहराई में जाओगे, जितनी आप परतों से अंदर के अंदर की तरफ जाओगे, उतना और वह निखर के आएगा. सो यस लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बी टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस वेरी फैसिनेटिंग आर्ट एंड क्राफ्ट एंड करियर एंड प्रोफेशन ऑफ एक्टिंग. एंड वी विल ट्राई अंडरस्टैंडिंग द वेरियस करियर अपॉर्चुनिटीज विच आर देयर इन एक्टिंग एंड हाउ यू कैन एक्चुअली इवॉल्व एंड further groom yourself in your profession and you can grow in the profession of acting. So aaj ka hamara jo ye webinar hai, ye unke liye bhi hai jo acting profession ko pursue karna chahte hain aur unke liye bhi hai jo already actors hain par is profession mein apne aap ko aur apne hunar ko nikhalna chahte hain, grow karna chahte hain, evolve karna chahte hain. And with through this we are going to be, as we move into this webinar, we are going to be taking it in the form of a conversation. And today we have a very renowned TV, film and theater personality, someone who's actually an electronics engineer by qualification and also done his MBA, but then he has more than 2.5 decades of extensive experience in the media and entertainment space. Jinhone apne career ki shuruaat ki thi 1994 mein, serial jo aata tha Shanti, and since then there has not been any looking back for him. And it is not just the Hindi medium or the Hindi film, TV and theater which he has explored, but in fact he has expanded his horizon, also moved into the regional. So it's been Marathi, Punjabi and even Telugu which he has explored. और जैसे जैसे ये इनको भी एक्सप्लोर करते गए, काफ़ी सारे इन्होंने और किरदार निभाए और सभी किरदारों को, बहुत ही विभिन्न किरदारों को इन्होंने बहुत ही बखूबी से निभाया. तो बिफोर आई गेट इनटू द कन्वर्सेशन विद हिम, लेट्स हैव अ व्यू इन ऑफ हिज इमेंस वर्क. Okay, yes, ladies and gentlemen, our special guest for today is Mr. Amit Behel, and as you know that he's a very renowned TV, film and theatre actor. He's also the Senior Joint Secretary of CINTA, which is the Cine and Television Artists Association, and he's also the member of the Governing Council of MESC. So it's my pleasure, delight to be welcoming Mr. Amit Behel here. I think we can all put our hands together. जब अपने घरों में आप तालियों के साथ उनका स्वागत कर सकते हैं, you can actually also snap your fingers, tap your feet. Can I have Mr. Behel joining us?
Good morning, Vinny. Yeah. Good morning.
Good morning. Such a delight to have you. Really an honor. थैंक यू सो वेरी मच. और बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है कि हम अपने घरों में, यू नो, कोविड हैज बीन एक्चुअली अ बून फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस आल्सो. इवन यस्टरडे व्हेन मिस्टर टेरेंस लुईस वाज देयर, वी वर एक्चुअली डिस्कसिंग कि घर में बैठ के हम एक दूसरे से इस तरह से बात करते हैं. टेक्नोलॉजी इज प्लेइंग अ टेरिफिक रोल टुवर्ड्स इट. सो वेरी हार्टी वेलकम एंड
थैंक यू सो मच. आई मीन इट्स thanks to technology. I'm just thinking agar if we didn't have these aids, the technology aids, so many years ago, or if this pandemic was to hit us, then maybe ye hum is tarah se rubaru nahi ho pate, and maybe we would have not been able to take advantage of a situation which is actually affecting the world, and not only the media and entertainment industry, the entire world. So ek isko ek jaise gujarati mein kehte hain ki ek loss ma profit thai gyu. So it is I think I always an optimist, and I think this is the best way to actually get across to people aspirants, and also this is something that I'm very happy to do as part of Vidyadhan, because I feel that there is something that I need to give back to the industry from which I've gained so much, and which has given me a whole lot of success in terms of name, fame, and of course a little bit of money also.
In fact, as you rightly said, that Vidyadhan has been a platform where people like you come and we talk to you, and it is through your experiences, through your conversations, through your experiential learning and your journey, your triumphs, tribulations, successes, failures, we try to understand that profession, and our audience, our viewers, can take a more informed decisions regarding their career. So my very first question, which I wanted to take, is that if you can share with us, if you can take us through your journey, how did you get into acting? As you know, aap electronic engineering kar rahe the, uske baad MBA kiya aur fir acting. So acting shuru se hi aap karna chahte the, matlab jaise dil mein acting thi, to jaise us samay ka hota tha ki certain professions you choose or parents tell you. But then acting happens. So if you can just take us through the journey, I'm sure it's going to be a lot of learning for everyone.
See, I went to a very good school in Mumbai called the Jamnabai Nursery School, which has obviously produced a lot of people from the film industry, actors, directors, writers, DOPs. But I came from a family wherein my father was in the Indian Navy, and he was an engineer with the Indian Navy, and my mother was the head of the Department of Hindi at Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan in Mumbai, and she was also senior reader at the Mumbai University. So, and also she was the head of the Punjabi Association, the Hindi Sahitya Sangh. So, through her attending the annual days of Bhavan's College, Mumbai University, there was definitely this great exposure that I got to. Seeing people perform on stage, people coming, taking part in elocutions, and as a child, also having witnessed people like Pandit Narendra Sharma, Harindranath Chattopadhyay, Dr. Rai Masoom Raza, Harivansh Rao Bachchanji coming to our house, and literary discussions happening, Kaifi Saab, then Ali Sardar Jafri. So these people coming at home definitely have had an influence that it's the creative arts is something that I want to be in, but. And of course, the school was very, very encouraging, because our annual days, the plays that we used to have for our annual days, the annual days used to run for 4 days, and they used to be performed at the Bhaidas Auditorium, which is a very popular and a huge auditorium in Mumbai. And uski taiyari, matlab 2-2.5 mahine ki rehearsals, then getting into costume, into makeup. So there was a magic to the entire thing, and then transforming yourself into somebody else. But aise hota hai ki 10th tak aapko samajh mein nahi aata. the bug had definitely hit me. This is something that I really wanted to do. But obviously, there is a standard process which everybody says, ki, no. Us zamane mein to engineering hota tha ya medicine hota tha. Ya phir jo log commerce stream mein to chartered accountancy. There was nothing else. And so, didn't want to get into science, but got into science. But continued with elocutions, debates, jams, quizzes, mono acting, creative writing, plays. So internally, without realizing it, my craft was being honed. Public speaking skills ho jaye, yeah. So this, aap realize nahi karte ki ye aapke basic being ke andar already ek aa raha hai. Ab 11th bhi kar li, 12th bhi kar li, unfortunately marks bhi achhe aa gaye. Aur mummy badi khush thi ke you know my son is doing well in studies and he's also doing well for himself in extracurricular activities. I was representing Maharashtra in basketball. So I was decent in sports. I was doing very well in winning prizes on all intercollegiate levels. But abhi marks achhe aa gaye, to parents ne kaha, bhai, you have to science lena nahi chah raha tha, arts lena chah raha tha, journalism karna chah raha tha, literature karna chah raha. 11th mein, I remember I was in the 11th and Firoz Abbas Khan, jinhone Gandhi my father direct kiya, to Firoz bhai had directed me in school for a play written by Kader Khan called Badi Der Kar Di Meherban Aate Aate. And that gave me the confidence to do actually a full-length performance of a 1 hour. And I was appreciated. Great rigorous rehearsals. Then I saw Firoz bhai on stage in a play called Ekshaf with him and Shafi Namdar. And the magic of the stage to see Firoz bhai performing. Then I saw the same play in Gujarati called Tokhar with Paresh Rawal on stage. One performance at Prithvi and one performance at Bhai Das. I was glued. I was mesmerized. I said, ki, this is what I want to do. And I think I can do it. I have been talking in front of a public platform. Meri Hindi theek thaak hai. I understand English. I have studied literature. But ek self is ek hota na ki bhai ek, you also assume that you're good. Ab engineering mein aa gaya. Ab engineering bhi aisa tha jis Ram Rao Adi Institute of Technology, which is part of the D.Y. Patil University. D.Y. Patil is now very famous because of the U2 concert and the IPL and stuff. So, and I went to an engineering college, and engineering and cultural activities were absolutely not connected to each other, because and mom and dad were very clear ke engineering kar le, uske baad dekhte hain kya hota hai. So academically I was there, but only about 20% of my heart and soul was there. I never wanted to actually do a course which was so boring and mundane with the applied chemistry and physics and operations research and mathematics and engineering drawing. All, matlab just cheeze, I was looking at art, literature, history, philanthropy, philosophy, psychology, visual arts, paintings. These were the things that were exciting me.
All creative fields.
Absolutely, all creative fields. So these were, but anyway, I have no regrets that I did my engineering, because it gave me a little bit of an analytic bone to understand life as the way it should be. But wahan par bhi engineering mein aake, because our college was very, very encouraging, so we formed our own cultural contingent. Then later on, I became the cultural secretary of the college and the general secretary of the college. And I was very fortunate to have a senior of mine who was anyway doing a lot of work professionally as a musician and as a singer. I mean, Padma Awardee Shankar Madhavan. So Shankar was two batches my senior in college. And Shankar and me formed a formidable team in the intercollegiate sector. So we two log jate the, ek unknown Ram Rao Adi Institute of Technology, jisko log, aur har intercollegiate festival mein, nationwide festival mein, मतलब बहुत ढेर सारे प्राइजेस बटोर के लाते थे. उसके बाद इंजीनियरिंग भी हो गई. एंड व्हाइल आई वाज इन द फाइनल ईयर, फिरोज अब्बास खान स्टार्टेड हिज फर्स्ट प्रोफेशनल प्रोडक्शन विद इन कोलैबोरेशन विद द पृथ्वी थिएटर कॉल्ड द रॉयल हंट ऑफ द सन. एंड बिकॉज आई हैड वर्क्ड विद फिरोज भाई इन स्कूल एंड देन लिटिल बिट इन कॉलेज, ही कास्ट मी इन दैट. एंड दैट्स द टाइम आई रियलाइज्ड दैट आई हैव टू डू दिस. मतलब देयर इज इन नो वे दैट आई कांट डू इट. ओके, ये भी हो गया. इंजीनियरिंग के रिजल्ट्स आ गए, पास्ड विद ऑनर्स. बट मॉम एंड डैड सेड कि अमित, इट्स हाई टाइम दैट यू टेक अ जॉब. So what had happened was that time I had started working with the Little Prithvi players under Veena Panni Chawla and Sanjana Kapoor, and also working with Iqbal Raj's theatre group Hetu plus Firoz Abbas Khan, and also doing a lot of street plays. I got a job and I would just wait. Luckily, the job was in sales. So my first job was with ICI and Fujitsu. So computer sales. तो महीने मतलब दिन में दो तीन घंटे सेल करके सीधा भाग जाता था रिहर्सल्स के लिए बिकॉज़ देयर हैज़ टू बी रिहर्सल्स एवरी इवनिंग. आफ्टर दैट दिस इज द टाइम व्हेन माय जूनियर फ्रॉम स्कूल अंकुश मौला हु इज अ वेरी रेनाउंड यू नो डायरेक्टर इन टीवी एंड ही इज आल्सो डन सम फिल्म्स सो दे वर्क इन द टीम ऑफ ग्लेन अंकुश. ही इज मैरिड टू अनदर फेमस एक्ट्रेस मीता बंसल. अंकुश वाज असिस्टिंग मंसूर खान ऑन अ फिल्म कॉल्ड जोजी तवा सिकंदर. And Mansoor had seen me in one play in Prithvi, and Mansoor really was keen to meet me. So I was shortlisted. I had a screen test for the role that eventually Mamik played in Jojita Was Sikandar. And at the same time, Dr. Chandraprakash was casting for Chanakya, and he had almost shortlisted me for the role of Chandragupta Maurya. That's the time when mom and dad said, over our dead body will you act. Acting is great as a part-time hobby. Great, मतलब आप इंजीनियर हो, you're wasting all this and ये वो over a dead body. And unfortunately, my resume was sent to a company in Delhi which was specializing in biomedical electronics and import of biomedical electronic equipment. And it was so I was forced to go to Delhi and give up all these hopes. Had said no to Dr. Saab and said no to Mansoor. मैं दिल्ली पहुंच गया और 91 और उससे पहले आई वॉज जजिंग कॉम्पिटिशन लाइक मल्हार एंड मूड आई एंड स्टफ बिकॉज आई ऑलरेडी टच वुड मेड अ मार्क फॉर माई सेल्फ इन द थिएटर सीन एट पृथ्वी एंड द अदर थिएटर्स देयर. सो वो मतलब मन पे तन पे अंतरात्मा पे पत्थर रख के मैं दिल्ली पहुंचा. और दिल्ली में 91 अगस्त से लेके 91 दिसंबर तक मैं मंडी हाउस के चक्कर भी नहीं लगाता था बिकॉज आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू कट दैट पार्ट ऑफ माई लाइफ. तो मैं अपने एक जिसको कहते हैं कि अपने जहन का अपनी आत्मा का एक हिस्सा मार रहा था रोज. I went to watch a play with some of my cousins in at the Kamani Auditorium in Delhi, and it was Amir Raza Hussain's Bit on the Side. And Amir Raza Hussain's production manager recognized me from some of my productions earlier, and they were casting for One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest for somebody to play Jack Nicholson's role. And Amir met me. Then there were no mobiles at that time, so mera jo company accommodation ke PP number per call aya. Amir said, I want to meet you. I said, no, sir. I have shut this part of my life. I don't think I'll ever act. I don't think I'll ever get into the public space, into media, nothing. I just don't know. Just come and meet me at least. So Malcha Marg went to his house and I read for it. And he says, this is great. So you and me are double cast and we have to do this. And then, wohi tha ke 9 to 5 job karo Okhla mein. उसके बाद 5 o'clock टेक एन ऑटो रिक्शा और टेक अ डीटीसी रश टू आमिर्स हाउस टू रिहर्स. देन ऑफ कोर्स द रीडिंग स्टार्टेड द रिहर्सल स्टार्टेड एट सरदार पटेल विद्यालय एंड देन ऑफ कोर्स टू स्टार्ट परफॉर्मिंग एट कमानी ऑडिटोरियम. उसके 10 शोज किए. अगेन प्रेशर कि मत करो यू आर यू नो रूइनिंग योर लाइफ. सो लाइफ चेंज फॉर मी इन 1992 व्हेन आई डिड अ वर्कशॉप इन मैक्सिमिलो भवन विद वन ऑफ दिल्लीज Premier, one of India's oldest groups, which has got people like Joy Michael, Abhijit Dutt, and Sai Paranjpe, and Vijaya Mehta. They've all been part of this group. It's old. Sushma Seth, Roshan Seth. These people have been part of the theatre group. So, did a big workshop with Yatrik. At the same time, Alkazi Saab, Shri Ibrahim Alkazi, who's the founder director of the National School of Drama, who's Padma Vibhushan, Kalidas Samman, and considered to be one of the greatest teachers of acting in the world. Somebody who's trained people like Nasiruddin Shah and Ayan Om Puri and Pankaj Kapoor and Raghuveer Yadav and Surekha Sikri. So Alkazi Sahib was starting his academy called the Living Theatre Academy of Drama, which was for actors who already had a prior experience. And this was going to be a performance-oriented academy. Every 6 months or 3 months, we would rehearse, read, work on a play, work on a script. It was an advanced course in acting. And primarily aimed at the stage. And without telling my bosses, I sent the pre-app. Aur wo pre-app karke Alkazi Saab saw, because I had done a lot of work compared to the other actors who must have applied. And Mr. Alkazi calls on my care-off number. And it was a dream to hear Mr. Alkazi. He says, so Mr. Behel, I'd like to meet you. And I went to meet him at the Art Heritage, which is, you know, a gallery at Triveni Kala Sangam near Mandi House. And to see this man who's considered to be the god of Indian theatre talking to you for about 2 hours. And he says, I know you have your qualifications in terms of you've done so much of theatre and professional theatre in Mumbai, but no, I want to audition you. And obviously, as usual, I chickened out. On the day I had my auditions, I had a job assignment to do with for the office. Mujhe ek sales call pe jana tha, Gangaram Hospital mein machine bechni thi aur All India Institute of Medical Sciences. Well, my job was technical training and training doctors all over the country and selling them high-end equipment, especially ophthalmology and in vitro fertilization equipment and high-end CT scanners. You know.
In fact, so entirely different.
yeah. In fact, I am the first engineer to introduce no-stitch cataract surgery, jisko aaj bahut common mante hain, and the spectacle removal surgery, jisko LASIKs kehte hain. So yeah. LASIKs and phaco emulsification were introduced by me because I was trained in Italy and France for it. And so imagine. So this was totally, but I was enjoying it. Why? Because it was technical selling. But again, I was sailing in too many boats. So anyway. जिस दिन ऑडिशन की बारी आई तो वहां पर जोहरा सेगल, मनोहर सिंह और अमाल अलाना, ये मतलब बाप लोग हैं और इनके सामने आई वाज सपोज्ड टू गो इन ऑडिशन बिकॉज़ द फर्स्ट डे आई हैड मिस्ड द ऑडिशन एंड हिज असिस्टेंट कॉल्ड मी कि मिस्टर अलकाजी वाज वेरी अपसेट एटलीस्ट कम टुमारो नाउ आई हैड नॉट प्रिपेयर्ड एनीथिंग व्हेन आई रीच्ड टू देयर इन द त्रिवेणी बेसमेंट आई सी दीज यू नो बिग डैडी स्टैंडिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी एंड इट वाज क्रेजी and Mr. Alkazi, obviously, in the disciplinarian that I'd heard of him, he shouted and he screamed at me. And finally, I told him, sir, I don't think I can perform. And he just started egging me on. He says, you're making a mockery of this art and so on and stuff. And suddenly something happened. And I performed a piece that I'd done earlier in one of my plays. And he asked me to stop midway. And he says, go. His assistant calls me in the night that you're on, you're selected for the academy. So September 1992 is when I got into the academy, and from October 1992 till 94, I was working with Yatrik, with Safdar Hashmi's group, Jannat Manch. I was also working with Alkazi Saab, plus doing a whole lot of freelance assignments regarding voiceovers and street theater and working with the
This is along with your job.
Along with my job. And finally, my bosses told me in December 93 that... you're great at your job. You've given us a lot of sales, but this can't go on. I said, okay, if this can't go on, what? He said, I think we should part ways. I said, cool. So from a company accommodation, I moved to a small Barsati in Sarai Julena because I had to complete Alkazi Saab's place.
From and your parents knew about it?
Sure. My parents knew about it. They were very upset, very pissed off. But I told them, I said, whatever I have to do, I'll come and talk to you once I come back to Mumbai. So 1993, December se leke March... 94 or April 94 tak main Delhi raha Barsati mein. Alkazi Saab gave me a small stipend, a scholarship, and because the new round of plays were happening. So by that time, we did Virasat, which is Vada Cherabandi part 1, 2 and 3. We did the Royal Hunt of the Sun, which I had done with Firoz in English. Now I was doing it in Urdu with Alkazi Saab. I also did two plays with Jannat Manch, including Satyashodhak, which we performed at the Prithvi Fest also. Then I did a lot of work with Yatrik. We did a play with him called Kismat Yaar. Did two workshops with Max Miller Bourbon on Grips Theatre. Also did a lot of workshops on street theatre. Traveled the country. And so 94, I performed The Three Sisters and Anton Chekhov's Three Sisters for Alkazi Saab. And we were rehearsing for the Greek tragedies and Streetcar Named Desire. But that's the when I realized my pocket was absolutely empty. Mom and Dad were giving me grief. And so 94, I came to Mumbai and again, got a job in Mumbai, again in Wipro, in Blue Star Medical Division, again selling, CT scanners and MRIs and EEG and these equipments, and again doing theater with my old group. It's crazy because I'm talking about April 94, they had already started casting for Shanti. Okay. I was not aware of it. Or ये हुआ कि महेश अलकुजवार जो कि बहुत ही बड़े प्ले राइट हैं और जिन्होंने गोविंद दलानी की बहुत सारी फिल्में लिखी हैं जो और जिनके नाटक काफ़ी चर्चित हैं और अलकुजवार साहब का प्ले हमने किया हुआ था तो अलकुजवार मुंबई आए हुए थे एंड ही कॉल्ड मी ऑन माय लैंडलाइन ही सेज अमित लेट्स मीट मैं मिला और मैं ऑलमोस्ट रो दिया मैं कहा सर मुझे ये सब नहीं करना वो एक्ट तो ही सेज ठीक है काम कर मेरी एक ऑटोग्राफ किताब है वो गोविंद लालानी के पास पहुंचानी है, उसके अंदर तो अपनी फोटोग्राफ स्लिप कर दे और चले जा, और उसी बहाने तरह स्ट्रगल भी हो जाएगा और ये किताब भी पहुंच जाएगी। मैंने कहा ठीक है। तो मैं गया, गोविंद लालानी साहब उस टाइम द्रोकाल फिल्म की एडिट कर रहे थे राजकमल स्टूडियोज में, विच बिलोंग्स टू वी शांताराम जी। वहाँ गया और उनको वो किताब दी, प्रतिबिंब नाम की उनकी एक नाटक है उनका, उसके अंदर मेरे फोटोग्राफ्स थे। तो देखा उन्होंने, बोले ये क्या? मैंने कहा सर मैं आई एम फ्रॉम लिविंग थिएटर और मेरा ये बैक। ही लुक्ड एट मी, उस टाइम घने बाल थे मेरे और मतलब टिपिकल यंग पंजाबी गुड लुकिंग नॉर्थ इंडियन बॉय। एंड ही सेड आई डोंट वर्क विद पीपल विद फेसेस लाइक यू। देन ही शोड मी फेसेस ऑफ आशीष विद्यार्थी एंड मनोज वाजपेयी एंड ओम पुरी। आई वर्क विद रियल फेसेस, है ना? Manoj was doing a very small part in Drokal. He says, yeah, these faces, I want to work with real faces. To David Dhawan ke paas chale ja. Achha. So he, from a landline, called up Mehboob Studio. That was great of him. Called up Mehboob Studios, and Mehboob Studios mein, his assistant told him, told Govindji, ke bhej do usko itne itne time. So Rajkamal Studios se main chale gaya Mehboob Studio. Wahan par entry bhi nahi mil rahi thi. तो फाइनली फिर वाया 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 मैंने कहा कि भाई इसके थ्रू इनके थ्रू इनके थ्रू आए हैं। एंड फाइनली आई वाज देयर एंड डेविड धवन जी वाज डायरेक्टिंग गोविंदा एंड संजय दत्त इन आई एम फॉरगेटिंग द नेम ऑफ द फिल्म बट आई थिंक दैट सॉन्ग व्हिच हैड अनटेक ऑफ फंडा यू नो सो दे वाज डायरेक्टिंग दैट एंड आई वाज स्टैंडिंग देयर एंड ही लुक्ड एट मी हां गोविंद जी ने भेजा ना हां सो ही कॉल्ड फॉर अ ब्रेक द शॉट वाज बीइंग सेट एंड ही ऑफर्ड मी अ कप ऑफ टी एंड ही सेज कि देख अमित तेरा बायोडाटा बहुत अच्छा है, तूने अच्छा काम किया है, गोविंद जी ने भेजा है, बट मैं स्टार्स के साथ काम करता हूँ यार। मैंने कहा अच्छा। एक तरफ आर्ट सिनेमा जो थिएटर वालों का एक मसीहा होता है, उसने रिजेक्ट कर दिया, यहाँ कमर्शियल मेकर ने भी रिजेक्ट कर दिया, क्या करूँ मैं? तो ये ट्रेनिंग का क्या करूँ? सो एनीवे बड़ा डिजेक्टेड होके मैं अंधेरी स्टेशन पहुंचा। अंधेरी स्टेशन के पीसीओ से मैंने अलकाजी साहब के असिस्टेंट को फोन किया कि मैं वापस आ रहा हूँ, मेरा नहीं हो रहा, आई कांट डू दिस जॉब एंड ऑल दैट। और अलकाजी साहब ने मुझे डांट दिया, मतलब ही रिप्ड मी अपार्ट। ही सेड यू विल ऑलवेज सेल इन टू बोट्स, यू विल नेवर अचीव एनीथिंग। इफ यू हैव टू लर्न टू स्विम, यू नीड टू जंप इनटू द वाटर। तब तक टिकट तो मैंने बुक कर ली, अलकाजी साहब की डांट भी खा ली। मैं पृथ्वी थिएटर पहुंचा, वहां पे अनुराग कश्यप, राजेश जैस और जीतू शास्त्री। अनुराग और हम जन्नाटक मंच में साथ में थे, राजेश जैस और जीतू शास्त्री एनएसडी के सीनियर्स हैं हमारे, तीनों मिले। बोले क्या हुआ क्या हुआ हमें? तुम्हें कहा यार मैं वापस जा रहा हूँ दिल्ली यार, यार नहीं हो रहा है कुछ। बोले तू तो बम्बई वाला। मैंने क्या बम्बई वाला? मम्मी पापा ने भी घर से निकाल दिया देश के, अगर तू भी इस टाइम जॉब छोड़ के बार बार इसमें घुस रहा है तो यू गो एंड स्टे समवेयर एल्स, वी कांट हैंडल दिस। तो बोले कहाँ? मैंने कहा वो रेंटल अकोमोडेशन में रह रहा हूँ मैं, फिल्म वाले स्टूडियो के पास अभी। अच्छा ओहो। अनुराग ने मेरे को बोला कि अमित एक मिनट। इट स्टक हिम दैट पार्थो मित्रा, who was also, you know, a very famous TV director, who's directed, Ye Mohabbat Hai, who's directed Kusum, who's directed Kavyanjali. He's directed all the top TV shows. Partho Mitra had seen my work in Delhi. Partho met Anurag and Partho had told Anurag, I'm looking for this actor called Amit Bahl, jo Delhi se Bombay shift hua hai. Ek character hai, main soch raha hu usko uske liye. So, Anurag ne mujhe ek number diya, UTV ke casting ka. Aur, maine kaha, maine coin nahi hai mere paas. अनुराग ने मुझे दो एक एक रुपए के सिक्के दिए। मैंने उस नंबर पे फोन किया, कास्टिंग डायरेक्टर शफी नामदार साहब के छोटे भाई सुहेल नामदार थे, उन्होंने फोन उठाया और कहा अरे हाँ तुम्हारे बारे में सुना है, ऑडिशन के लिए आ जाओ अभी। मैंने कहा अभी? कहता हाँ ऑडिशन चल रहा है। कहा अच्छा। और मैं ऑफिस के कपड़ों में था, मतलब विद माई टाई एंड माई ब्रीफकेस एंड एवरीथिंग, सो आई वाज लाइक रियली मिसफिट। वापस आया तो अनुराग ने बोला क्या हुआ? बोले वो बुला रहे हैं। बोले जा। मैं कहा यार अब मेरे पास पैसे भी नहीं है। सो अनुराग गेव मी 50 bucks एंड जीतू एंड राजेश ने मिलकर 30 rupees और दे दिए, तो 80 rupees मेरे पास। तो फिर पृथ्वी थिएटर से ऑटो रिक्शा टू विलेपार्ला स्टेशन, विलेपार्ला स्टेशन टू एल्फिंस्टन रोड, एल्फिंस्टन रोड से शेयर अ टैक्सी, पहुंच गए जी वहाँ पे। वहाँ देखा तो वहाँ तो सब 8-pack वाले, तो 100 लोग खड़े हुए, बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स, मॉडल्स एंड ऑल रिहर्सल। मैं कहा अपना तो होगा। देखिए मैंने गेम ये स्क्रिप्ट, मैंने स्क्रिप्ट देखी, जैसे स्क्रिप्ट देखी ऑल माई इमोशनल मेमोरी, क्राफ्ट मेमोरी, आर्ट मेमोरी, माई टैलेंट इफ यू कैन कॉल इट, सब आया। एंड आई सेड ओके दिस वाज, आई एम गोइंग टू गिव अ शॉट। वेंट इनसाइड, सोहेल वाज देयर, ही सेड यू रेडी? आई सेड रेडी। फर्स्ट टाइम आई एम फेसिंग द कैमरा, पुट द कैमरा ऑन एंड सडनली आई सेड दिस इज व्हाट आई वांट टू डू, एंड ये किया। अगले दिन पार्थो गिव्स मी अ कॉल, आई वांट टू मीट यू। वेंट एंड मेट पार्थो, ही सेड आई लाइक योर वर्क अमित, आई वांट यू इन द शो, बट दिस इज अ 4-part रोल, जस्ट 4 episodes। सो आई सेड आई स्टिल डू इट बिकॉज़ यू नो कैमरे के सामने दिखना है, पता तो चले कितने पानी में. अंधों में काना राजा कहो या द ऑडियंस लव्ड मी कहो. 15th अगस्त 1994 शांति का पहला एपिसोड टेलीकास्ट हुआ. माय एंट्री वाज इन द सेकंड और द थर्ड एपिसोड. 22 अगस्त 1994 मेरी जिंदगी बदल गई थी जब मैं ट्रेन पकड़ने ऑफिस जा रहा था. सडनली एवरीबडी स्टार्टेड सेइंग अरे ये तो विजय है, विजय. दैट वाज माय कैरेक्टर इन शांति. ये तो विजय है, विजय है, विजय. आई सेड कुछ तो बदला है. और जॉब चल रहा था, थिएटर भी चल रहा था और शांति भी चल रही. इट वॉज क्रेजी. मतलब मैं कितने नाव में सवार था मुझे ही नहीं मालूम. उसी बीच में पल्लवी जोशी वॉज मेकिंग अ होम प्रोडक्शन आरोहन. और आरोहन में जो विवेक अग्निहोत्री ने भी डायरेक्ट किया था. सो पल्लवी गॉट टू नो ऑफ मी फ्रॉम समबडी. पल्लवी मेट मी एंड ऑफ कोर्स आई वाज अ ग्रेट फैन ऑफ पल्लवीज एंड मेट एंड आई प्लेड हर एल्डर ब्रदर. नाउ आरोहन वाज अ बिग शो बिकॉज़ ऑल्दो वी वर ऑल स्ट्रगलर्स एंड न्यूकमर्स एट दैट टाइम बट इट हैड पीपल लाइक शेफाली शाह एंड हर्ष शाह एंड परवीन दस्तूर एंड तरुण धनराजगीर एंड अंजू महेंद्रू एंड पल्लवी हरसेल्फ एंड माधवन एंड इट वॉज क्रेजी. सत्यन कपूर साहब. सो इट वॉज वन ह्यूज show on women in the Indian Navy and I was playing her elder brother in EPSOS officer. And so camera facing single camera ki facing wahan se hui aur three camera setup jo Shanti tha which was India's first daily show which was being shot like an international. Ye chalta raha till 95 March when my bosses in Blue Star found out ke ye sala jhol kar raha, you know, he's not He's good at his job. He's good at his job. Yeah, but where does he disappear? I was supposed to make a presentation for my bosses on acquiring a new company, and it seemed there was a cricket match which was on because tabhi sirf Zee aaya tha. Okay, so they put on Doordarshan, and instead of the cricket match coming on, they suddenly see my face. All the country bosses plus the international principals, they suddenly see this. 15 minutes later, I'm there in the conference room. I just apologize for the 10 minutes delay. Let's start the presentation. The presentation goes on well. They get the deal. And in the evening, the boss calls me to his house. Says, beta, tu chhod. That's the time when Alkazi Saab also called me, ki, you are not going to listen to me. I will disown you. That's the time I realized that I have to now quit. Because tab tak Blue Star had spent a lot of money on me. I had gone to the US. So I spent about 8 months doing Shanti and doing theater and training the next person for whatever I'd learned in Blue Star. And then March 95 se aaj tak I'm a full-time actor, and that is lagbhag my journey.
Such an interesting journey. In fact, wo gana hai na, na na karte pyaar tumhi se kar baithe. So engineering, MBA, job.
MBA toh main bhool gaya. Yeah, so while I was working in Delhi, so... because I'd already finished 3 years of working in Mumbai Milake. So I got into FMS to do their part-time course. And that was very stressful because FMS is, they're very, very, you know, conscious about...
that also from a prestigious institute. FMS mein to admission mil rahi. So tough.
So ye FMS, theater. मतलब वो 95, 96 मुझे याद है जब मैं सिर्फ एक full-time actor बना था, तब मैंने realize किया कि पिछले 6 साल मेरे जिंदगी के कितने नावों में गए मुझे समझ में नहीं
आया. Here I will just cut you here. तो आपका जो जर्नी रही सारी, जैसे as I understand, घर का थोड़ा सा माहौल था, आपको एक्सपोजर मिला, your interest started getting developing. Then you joined the theatre, आप साथ साथ थिएटर करते रहे, तो वही था कि जैसे दिल तो वहां पर था. पर आजकल के टाइम में if someone wants to enter into acting, take pursue it, how important it is to first undergo a training, join some academy, join some institute, and then move into it. And especially as it is so very competitive, and there is again so much technology also which is there. So, aapki taraf se ki jaise wo ek thi ke passion hoti hai, lagan hoti hai, aapko thoda sa andar se bhi lagta hai ki haan main ye kar sakta hu. Par groom hoke hi jaye is field mein, what's your view on that?
We were very unfortunate at that time. I feel very unlucky ke bhai mere, I could not enter the National School of Drama or FTI didn't have a acting course at that time. But I learned on the job. So I lost about 6 years. Hamare time pe internet nahi tha, digital nahi tha. Hamare time itni opportunities nahi thi. We just had, TV was just, you know, coming into inception. You had just the national broadcaster and Zee had just started. Opportunities nahi thi. Mobiles bhi nahi. Okay, mobiles just came in you know, end of 94, early 95. So, and there were no photo phones, you know, camera phones and stuff. I personally feel that right now, the way we stand is that, see, the most important thing for anybody getting into the field of performing arts or acting is self-analysis. Okay. And like Nasiruddin Shah puts it in this book, especially when it comes to acting, if in your life you have to decide between death and acting, then become an actor. Okay. Now, but having said that, that's a very extremist view that Nasir Bhai has taken, because he comes from a time which is a time which is much before us, when opportunities for them were only cinema, and that too, art house cinema, realistic cinema. But Nasir Bhai has been a successful actor on all formats. I mean, he's one of the greatest stage actors that I've seen in the world. The point is that the training helps you. Training will definitely help you. Training helps you understand your tools. Training helps you hone your skills. Training helps you to understand the difference between the mediums. Training also disciplines you. Training also helps you understand the business, and also helps you understand the formats of performance. Okay. Because today's day and time, see, gone are the days. I'm talking about the last 5-6 years. Nobody's got the time to recruit an apprentice. You could have an apprentice director. You can't have an apprentice actor. The actor is a frontline soldier. The actor is somebody who is supposed to have prepared for Kargil or Siachen at home or in his training institute. The moment he or she approaches the industry, inki tayari is assumed that they've done. So that is the difference, because hamare time pe ho sakta hai ki people were slightly more patient. But also, on a flip side, that we had some teachers, some directors, some DOPs who were so strict, who were so rude, who were so crass. And anybody who did not have a sense of patience and perseverance would have left the trade. Today's day, it's a crazy time, because the digital generation, the digital medium, access to various mediums of performance, access of reaching out to the stakeholders has become easier. But also, if the supply has, if the demand has increased, the supply is tenfold. The supply is tenfold, and the supply-demand ratio needs to be matched correctly for the correct person to reach the correct place. That is the difference, you know. That is, and but I personally feel that training from the correct institute, from the correct trainers, with the correct perspective, with an open mind, is the most important.
And before I move to my next question, I also wanted to thank SST College, which is a premier education institution at Udhasnagar. This was an institute which was established in the year 2004. They are affiliated to one of the oldest and prestigious university, that is the University of Mumbai, and they offer courses from junior college to post-graduation, and they are supporting the Creative Warrior program. So we thank them also. And all our viewers who are watching us, you can also take a selfie with Mr. Amit Behar. Or selfie ko aap apne social media par post kar sakte hain. Maximum likes. So tag kare zarur MESC ko aur Vidyadan ko. Aur maximum likes wale ko. Kal hum ek award, jo hai prize money, announce karenge. In fact, yesterday we had someone who had won an iPad. And today I also have the name of the winner. Let me announce her name also. We had Dharia Arora of yesterday, who was the winner. So continue to tag us, continue to take selfies, and we take this discussion and conversation forward. So isse mujhe aapne kaha ki jab aapne aap gaye role maangne ke liye ya jahan par creators mein gaye, aur to aapne apni photo एक किताब में डालकर आगे कर दी. तो मैं वो अंडरस्टैंड करना चाहती हूँ कि आजकल कैसे लोग रोल अपना अप्रोच करते हैं. ट्रेनिंग कर ली किसी ने, हो गया, मतलब उसने अपने हुनर को निखार दिया. नाउ ही इज एंटरिंग इन द वर्ल्ड, अब वो फील्ड में जा रहा है. तो हाउ डज ही अप्रोच वर्क, हाउ डज ही गो अबाउट, और किस तरह से अपना क्या पोर्टफोलियो बनाना पड़ता है, हाउ डज ही डू दैट?
हमारे जमाने में पोर्टफोलियो बनाना मैंने ऐसा होता था कि हार्ट अटैक, बिकॉज पोर्टफोलियो तो आपने बना लिया, लेकिन हर प्रिंट के 8 रुपए लगते थे.
Okay.
मतलब, So, you know, journeys of actors who started in the 90s is much different from people who started in the millennium, you know. Aaj ki date mein simple that you need to definitely get a decent portfolio clip, of course. And 90% of all casting directors and people who are looking at coordinating and are looking at real photos, realistic photos, not glossy and, you know, a lot of artwork done on them. A set of photographs is a must. But a great advantage for today's actors is that you don't need to submit physical prints. So it's just people mail them, WhatsApp them, send it on something else, you know. So that is a great advantage. You can keep, you know, just a physical folio for your own thing. But things have become much easier because the contacts for every casting director and every coordinator is now available on the net. So actors can uplink their photographs. Unfortunately, kya ho gaya ke lot of young aspirants wo kya karte hain, wo camera phone apne ghar pe rakh ke kuch ek filmi dialogue bol dete hain ya ek natak ka dialogue bol ke usko ek audition link karke bhej dete hain. This is not taken very seriously by people. In fact, casting directors and people who are recruiters get very upset. Because mujhe bhi ye lagta tha ki jab main aaine ke samne khade reh ke Amitabh Bachchan ke dialogue bolta tha ya Gregory Peck ke lines bolta tha ya you know talking about a line from The Godfather, aur mujhe bhi lagta ki main bhi Marlon Brando hu, main Amitabh Bachchan hu, main Balraj Sahni. Wo self realization aapko tab milti hai jab darshak aapke samne hote hain, jab casting director aapke samne hota hai, जब आपका थिएटर डायरेक्टर आपके सामने होता है, जब आपके क्रिटिक्स आपके सामने होते हैं, तो कंस्ट्रक्टिव रिजेक्शन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, सो कंस्ट्रक्टिव, इफ समबडी रिजेक्ट्स यू ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ अ फोटोग्राफ, व्हिच मींस दैट ही और शी इज नॉट लुकिंग एट ए पर्टिकुलर लुक, यू ऑब्वियसली कांट चेंज योर फिजिकल डायमेंशन. ओके, बट देर इज ए रोल एंड अ पार्ट फॉर एवरीबडी इन दिस ट्रेड. ओके, दैट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ऑल्सो people can, you know, people who are aspirants can also try playing with get-ups, with looks when they make a folio. Because kharcha ek hi baar karna hota hai. You pay for makeup or you pay for hair or you pay for, you know, prosthetics or you pay for costumes. So ek hi baar if you can experiment with looks. Hamare senior hai Gulshan Grover, who's, you know, everybody knows him, international actor.
Yeah.
Gulshan Grover ka basic forte that in almost every film he's experimented with his looks. So that is his forte. He's adopted a technique to get across to people. And jaise mujhe nahi malum tha ki main kaisa folio khichwaun. Mere to ek dost the jo table top photography karte the ads ke liye. Humari building mein rehte the. Maine kaha yaar kuch photo khich de yaar. Usne khich diya. Shanti serial ke set pe Vijay Bar se jo aaj ke day mein matlab India ke one of the top still photographers hain. Vijay ne kaha main chal tere photo khich deta hu. To wohi Shanti ke costume use karke studio ke bahar idhar udhar usne photo khich diya. I got my first folio click actually properly by late Jagdish Mali, who's the pioneer in photography, especially, I mean, somebody like all the top stars have got themselves, and his daughter Antara Mali was of course a film star also. So Jagdish Mali, when he saw me, when I had shaved my hair off, and he said, Amit, I like this look, main tera folio khichta hun. So main, after having been in the industry for 15-16 years also, I told him, Mali ji, aapke liye, aapke like paise nahi hai mere paas. इसे तेरा फ्री में करता हूँ, ये मेरा एक मेरा शोरील बन जाएगा. मैं तो ठीक है. सो बट टुडेज डे एंड टाइम देयर आर फोटोग्राफर्स गैलोर. आई मीन इन ऑल सिटीज देयर आर डीसेंट फोटोग्राफर्स. यू डोंट नीड टू कम टू मुंबई टू गेट योर फोलियो क्लिक. इट हैज टू बी अ रियल फोटो व्हिच एनहांसेस एंड योर स्ट्रक्चर, योर नुआंसेस, योर एक्सप्रेशंस. एंड ऑब्वियसली इफ यू आर ट्रेंड यू विल नो हाउ टू मेक let's say I will call it in a very very non-political way, love to the camera. So आपकी जो आपके expressions हैं, आपका camera के साथ जो affinity है, वो एक trained actor और untrained actor में फर्क पता चल जाता है, जब आपके folio से भी पता चल जाता है.
So portfolio is very necessary. और जैसा कि आपने कहा, different
get up. That's a show. आपका show. Yeah, bye. Yeah, actors are commodities and you have to show them on the shelf, right?
Yeah.
भाई रेन कैसा है, एरियल कैसा है, वो तो बाद की बात है. उसका पोस्टर तो पहले लगेगा ना, है ना. वॉशिंग पाउडर यूज तो बाद में करेंगे, पहले पोस्टर तो पता चले कि क्या है इसमें.
अच्छा, आप कोई ऑडिशन के लिए गया, उसको ऑडिशन के लिए कॉल आ गया, एंड ही गोस फॉर द ऑडिशन, हाउ डज ही प्रिपेयर हिमसेल्फ? मतलब पहले से बता दिया जाता है कि भाई आपको इस रोल के लिए आप तैयारी करके आओ, और कोई डायलॉग्स दे दिए जाते हैं, एंड देन यू You know, and another thing I wanted to ask, how do you remember the dialogues? क्योंकि सिर्फ dialogue को याद नहीं रखना, साथ में आपको expression लाना. So it is both things happening. तो audition देने से पहले क्या तैयारी होनी चाहिए?
देखिए पहले जमाने में क्या था, जब हमने स्टार्ट किया था कि there was no emailing कि भाई आपको स्क्रिप्ट ईमेल कर रहे हैं या कुछ, आपको बोला था कि ये रोल है, आप वहाँ पहुँच जाते थे. हम कोई 20-25 एक्टर्स, मुझे याद है कि मैं, कुमुद मिश्रा, आशुतोष राणा, सचिन खेड़ेकर, मनोज बाजपेयी, अनूप सोनी, माधवन, संजीव सेठ, गिरीश मलिक, ये सब हम लोग सभी, मतलब अब वो एक ही फर्रा हमको दिया गया है, वो फर्रा हम पढ़ रहे हैं जैसे, और वो फर्रा पढ़ रहे हैं, आपको आपकी बारी कब आएगी पता नहीं आप, ठीक है?
अच्छा, सभी को एक ही डायलॉग है,
एक ही डायलॉग, एक ही रोल के लिए, एक ही. हम जो आज 25 साल से यार दोस्त हैं, ऋतुराज हो गया, मतलब हम मोहन कपूर, वो एक ही ऑडिशन के लिए वही फेसेस दिखते थे, सब एक दूसरे के लिए म्यूचुअल रिस्पेक्ट होता था, एक दूसरे का काम जानते भी थे. एक ही लाइन लेके आप 10 बजे पहुंच के, हो सकता है आपकी बारी शाम को 4 बजे आए, तो एक ही फर्रा लेके आप रट रहे हैं कि भाई और कब आएगी बारी, है ना? और कितनी बारी होता था कि मेंटली फिजिकली आप एग्जॉस्ट भी हो जाते थे, इमोशनली आप ड्रेन हो जाते थे, आप यू आर नॉट एबल टू गिव अ गुड ऑडिशन. आज की डेट एंड टाइम में 90% ऑफ द कास्टिंग डायरेक्टर्स सेंड यू एन ऑडिशन स्क्रिप्ट ऑन व्हाट्सएप और ऑन मेल. Sometimes they also give send you an audio note और character sketches भी भेजते हैं, because कितनी बार ही हो जाता है कि आपको self test देने के लिए कहते हैं. Lot of people want you to come and audition for them in their auditioning studio, their offices or a place that they've booked for auditions. कितनी बार ऐसा होता है कि आपको अच्छी जी ये रोल है आप आइए, तो ऑडिशन की स्क्रिप्ट आपको एडवांस में भी नहीं दी जाती, मैक्सिमम हाफ एन आवर दिया जाता है तैयारी करने के लिए. इतनी बार ये होता है कि आपको एक महीना भी मिल जाता है, अगर इंटरनेशनल कास्टिंग एजेंसी है या कुछ लोग बहुत ज्यादा डेवलप करना चाहते हैं, वो आपको क्रिएटिव डायरेक्टर आपसे बात भी कर लेगा फोन पे, आपको ब्रीफ भी कर देगा कैरेक्टर का पास्ट प्रेजेंट फ्यूचर. ऑडिशन की सबसे बड़ी बात तो ये है कि भाई जो बेसिक कास्टिंग डायरेक्टर है वो ये चाहता है कि एक्टर कितनी अच्छी है, कितनी जल्दी अपनी लाइनें याद कर लेता है, स्पेशली इन टीवी, बिकॉज टीवी इज द अमाउंट ऑफ मिनट्स दैट यू शूट इन अ डे इज व्हाट द प्रोड्यूसर सेव्स. When we talk about a web series or we talk about cinema, they're still very focused on getting into character. So it's a mix of learning your lines, getting into character, how much you can improvise, and if they want you to improvise, not wanting you to improvise. So there are multifaceted or multi-pronged approaches to handling audition. Audition ki technique ke liye is a, I mean, there's a separate class or a workshop I can take on how do you handle audition. Because one thing for an actor is that any rejection in an audition should be taken positively. I mean, I do that even now. When I get rejected for a certain audition, I say, this is, you don't deserve me. Ho sakta hai ki uski kismat mein Amit Behal naam ka cake nahi tha. Hai na?
Uska loss hai.
Yeah, so that's what kept me alive. Secondly, an audition always should be taken as, oh, another opportunity to study another character, another set of lines, another dialect, at the cost of the producer and the customer. By Wi-Fi.
So you stand positive. कोई अच्छा ही होगा.
हाँ यार, Wi-Fi उसका, air condition उसका, camera उसका, चाय भी पिला रहा है आपको, है ना? और आपको कुछ और करने को मिल रहा है. So I always take it in a positive sense. But and learning lines. This is your question. Learning lines is something that is a lot of actors are blessed with photographic memory. I have been very, very, very fortunate. I think it's my upbringing as an engineer also, because of the amount of reading I've done as a child and the amount of jo mugging maine kiya apne engineering exams ke liye, ya phir God-given hai ya parents ka given hai. Touchwood, I'm very, very good with lines. That's why I've been able to experiment with all formats of performances. And very few actors my age have been given that opportunity by the God in the industry. Okay, I have been able to play classical roles, modern roles, roles on different levels, so that because of this photographic memory, and I have been able to save time for the producer also. Kai baar light ja rahi hoti hai, aapko ek lamba scene diya jata hai, so aapki emotional or photographic memory ka jo ek mishran hota hai, that creates a good time saving, life saving performance for a TV actor. In films it's different, in the web it's different, because the stakes are different. Aur 25 साल लग गए मुझे इसको थोड़ा बहुत समझने के लिए. मुझे लगता है होपफुली बिफोर आई रीच अ स्टेज वेयर आई एम टोटली इनवैलिड, I will be able to understand this complete thing. But it's a process, because when I speak to my seniors like Paresh Bhai or Naseer Bhai or Pankaj Kapoor, and when you see Mr. Bachchan in action and his photographic memory, his getting into the craft, taking the light, coming on the mark, being focused. So it's like, you know, you're batting. When you're batting with these stalwarts, you're actually playing the last ball of a T20 with five bowlers bowling at you. And that's the exciting part about being in the trade, because you're at war every day. And it's a war that you want to be a part of.
And then, so, aapne jaise vibhin kirdar nibhaye, and they're so very different. And especially when you're doing a historical character, Chanakya ka aapne kiya. So, to kaise iska, how do you transform yourself? Uske liye kis tarah se different? और आजकल इसलिए भी मैं आपसे पूछना चाहती हूँ कि यूजुअली जब भी कोई बॉलीवुड एंटर करता है, फिल्म से एंटर करता है, तो लगता है मैं तो हीरो बनने जा रहा हूँ. आजकल ठीक है, अ हीरो इज आल्सो ओके कंफर्टेबल एज अ विलन. यू नो, वी हैव आवर एक्टर्स हु आर प्लेइंग हीरो आल्सो, विलन आल्सो, डांसिंग आल्सो. पर पहले वो होता था कि यू वर टाइप कास्ट, आप हीरो हो, ये विलन है, ये वैम्प है, ये वो है. आजकल यू आर वन एंड ऑल. तो इतना स्विच ओवर करना अपने रोल्स में, किस तरह से, how does an actor do it?
I came at a time when the definition of the hero and the villain still existed. This entire definition has changed since the millennium, because sun 2000-2001 se all our leading actors have been playing different kinds of roles. Okay, when Nawaz has done some bit parts of roles and then suddenly he became the lead actor. Vicky Kaushal also did some bit parts when he became the lead actor. You have actors like Manoj Bajpayee who do lead roles and who also do supporting characters in a film like Special Chabbi. So when we talk about, I'm talking about myself, I never wanted to be a hero. I was mesmerized with the art and the craft of acting. I thought it's magic. Okay. Of course, our initial influences were people like Mr. Bachchan and were people Sylvester Stallone and stuff. But because of the persona that they created, not because it was glamour for me. And gradually I realized that this industry is not about glamour. It's about a lot of hard work. So sportsmen, actors, people on the front, and of course our COVID workers, we put in a lot of hard work. The point is that because meri Hindi ki training achhi thi, and very people, because ke bhai Mumbai mein rehne ke bawajood, because I was well versed with Hindi because of my mother, because I read a lot, aur kyunki maine itni public speaking ki thi, speeches yaad ki thi, elocutions bola, because I was brought up in a great school, I knew English literature. I grew up with a lot of Maharashtrians, so I knew Marathi. I had Gujarati neighbors, I knew Gujarati. I observed and listened to Urdu. Punjabi is my mother tongue. So I was able to grasp languages. Because I had done classical theater formats with Al-Qazi Sahib, having done Greek tragedies also, and having done classical theater like Chekhov. Ek ye to grasp, jisko hum kehte na, shuddh Hindi ya Sanskritized Hindi. Jab maine Amatya Rakshas kiya tha Ashoka mein, ya when I Upanishad Ganga, jo main kar raha hu, which is being shown on DD now, where I've played 52 characters in 52 different episodes. And every episode has got some phenomenal historical characters like Acharya Stuli Bhadra and Vidyaranya and Bhaskaracharya and Aryabhatta. And so, ab wo ek taraf se koi imagine nahi kar sakta that somebody who's so well-bred and speaking in English, which has got a, doesn't have a very, very Indian accent, and at the same time, aap shudh Hindi bhi kar rahe hai, phir aap Marathi bhi kar rahe hai. I have learned that the importance of the language is very, very there. This is there. Yeah. Or because aapko dialogue yaad karna to ek baat, us dialogue ka emotive meaning, context kya hai. Or what is the subtext between the lines? What is the essence of silence? What is the importance of a pause? What is the importance of registering or because you yourself are an anchor, you realize that how you accentuate or how do you focus or you emphasize on a certain thing. These are very, very important. Or har bhasha ke pronunciation emphasis alag hai. Jab maine abhi last year Telugu film jab ki thi, maine Sita. So I said, no, I will not do the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I want to, maybe you'll get a dub from somebody else, but I want to understand what I'm saying. Marathi comes very easily to be, Gujarati comes easily to be, because Mumbai mein rehne ke bawajood, मुंबई में रहने की वजह से हमारे को ये भाषाओं के साथ ये है. अब जब मैं स्वराज्य रक्षक संभाजी, जो कि मराठी सीरियल है, जो जी मराठी का फ्लैगशिप शो था, जिसमें मैं इकलौता खालिस उर्दू बोल रहा था, बिकॉज आई एम औरंगजेब इन दैट. तो वो उसके लिए एक तरफ आप शुद्ध हिंदी बोल रहे हैं, फिर आप खालिस उर्दू बोल रहे हैं, फिर आप एक गुजराती फिल्म कर रहे हैं. आई हैव लर्नड इट ओवर द इयर्स हाउ टू बैलेंस बिटवीन दीज लैंग्वेजेस, अंडरस्टैंड द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ एवरी लैंग्वेज एंड ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ द स्पोकन वर्ड, द स्पोकन वर्ड एंड द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ साइलेंस. ओके, तो ये बहुत जरूरी हो जाता है बिकॉज ये मेरी तैयारी है 25 सालों. बट आज की डेट में आई हैव सीन अ लॉट ऑफ एक्टर्स हु हैव gone through training and they've come with all their tayari. When you see an actor like Vicky Kaushal or an actor like Rajkumar Rao or an actor like Ayushman Khurana or somebody like Richa Chadda or Rasika Dugal or Nawaz for that matter. See, Manoj is somebody who's done so much of extensive theater and he's been a folk dancer. So Manoj is like a full package. Okay.
Yeah.
So, and like people like Naseer Bhai who are so very well bred in terms of their English and English literature. Mr. Bachchan, for that matter, Mr. Bachchan can move in with languages so easily. You know, he's also an English literature person, but because of Bachchan Saab, Ayushai Bachchan Saab, but also he's Bangla roots. He picks up Marathi also. He recites the the Ganpati Aarti also. So it's very important to be multifaceted. Very, very, very important. And these people are aware. So I keep my isko hum kehte na indriya aap khuli rakhi thi. So aapko grasping aapki jaldi hogi. And this is something that I'm still trying to better at.
What I can sense is, वो एक passion है, एक लगन है, और जब passion होती है ना, तो उतना आप और अपने आप को निखारने में, learn करने में, आपको मजा आता है कि और मैं सीखूं, और मैं सीखूं, कैसे इसको improve करूं?
Jimmy, in this trade or in the creative crafts, complacency is not accepted.
Yeah.
You have to be with the times. You have to have the hunger. You have to have the zeal. You need to know your positives and you need to know your negatives very, 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 very,
very, very. Okay, here I would also like to invite Roshni from MESC, if she can join. We'll take some questions also of the audience.
Roshni, if you can
join us. Achha, main aapse ye bhi poochna chahti thi, for an actor, again that switch off and switch on. Kabhi aap ghar se aaye, mood kharab tha, aage yahan par aapko koi romantic feel karna hai. So again, how do you switch off and switch on? फिर घर जा रहे हैं. Again, you're not carrying your work. You should not be carrying your work or a role at home. So how does an actor do that? How do again that balancing of switch off, switch on?
आपको अपना एक किस्सा बताता हूँ. 2013 में, it was the day of Anand Chaturdashi, and I got to know that my mother might have passed away. और मम्मी का देहांत हुआ. आई वेंट एंड सो माई ब्रदर ऑल्सो केम इन एंड वी परफॉर्म्ड द क्रिमेशन. और अगले दिन मैं एक लाइफ ओके पे शो कर रहा था सावित्री, जिसमें मुझे कॉमेडी सीन करना, जिसका टेलीकास्ट उस दिन रात को था. तो सुबह मैंने अस्थियां कलेक्ट की, उसको वहाँ स्टोरेज में रखा अपने भाई के साथ, और उसके बाद मैंने जाके कॉमेडी सीन्स किए. ऐसा ही हुआ था मेरे साथ दूसरी बार, जब मैं माई मदर इन लॉ वॉज I got to know that she is no more, and I had to do some action sequences for something called Shapath. I knew my father's also on his deathbed in 2017, and I was doing this show called Wo Apna Sa, for which I got the Zee Rishte Award also. Maine scene complete kiya, my wife called me, Papa's no more. I went, we got him, death certificate sab banke, got him home, went back to my house, completed two scenes, went and did the cremation. So switch on and switch off is part of an actor's life. Many a times, I'll tell you very honestly, कितनी बार मैं जब वो मतलब अर्थी उठा रहा था, मुझे लगा कि मैंने शायद ये सीन पहले किया हुआ है. तो कभी कभार एज एन एक्टर रील और रियल के बीच में डिफ्रेंशिएट करना थोड़ा कठिन हो जाता है. बट एक बात है, नेवर कैरी माई कैरेक्टर्स, ये तो मैं बात कर रहा हूँ सर्कमस्टेंस की, बट आई नेवर कैरी माई कैरेक्टर्स होम. I could be in the foulest of moods, but the moment the makeup dada starts putting this on, I have to forget all worries because the show must go on. This is showbiz, this is performance. ये एक ऐसा profession है जिसके लिए जो आपने चुना है, इसके hardships अगर if you have to wallow in this in your sorrow and all that, but you're also getting the gains in terms of people are liking you, loving you, or hating you, criticizing you. You're a public figure. You're getting to do what you love and getting paid for it. तो मैं कोशिश यही करता हूँ कि मैं कभी भी ये सारा बैगेज अपने साथ घर नहीं ले आऊं, बट समटाइम्स ए कैरेक्टर डज, मतलब एक मैं औरंगजेब जब मैंने 1.5 साल 1.5-2 साल किया, तो मेरे अंदर एक एक उस तरह का एक अहंकार, एक स्ट्रॉन्ग बिलीव, कितनी बार होता था कि आई वॉज रूड टू सम पीपल अराउंड मी, एंड देन आई रियलाइज कि नहीं भाई तू औरंगजेब नहीं है रियल लाइफ, तू अमित बहल है. ओके, तो ये हुआ मेरे साथ हाल ही में, वो इन स्पाइट ऑफ हैविंग डन सो मच ऑफ वर्क, बट वो कहीं ना कहीं एक बैलेंस, लिटिल बिट ऑफ मेडिटेशन, लिटिल बिट ऑफ ट्राइंग टू कट ऑफ, तो मुश्किल हो जाता है कभी कभार. आई ट्राई टू फाइंड अ बैलेंस, एंड दैट्स द बेसिक थिंग इज एक्टिंग इज अबाउट एक्टिंग एंड नॉट बीइंग द कैरेक्टर. यू बीइंग द कैरेक्टर ओनली व्हेन द व्हेन यू से स्टार्ट कैमरा टिल कट, बियॉन्ड दैट यू हैव टू बी नॉर्मल रियल, अदरवाइज यू कैन गो इन टू द प्रीसेंस ऑफ अ मेंटल असाइलम वेरी सून.
Yeah, exactly what you said also about meditation. I think वो भी एक calmness लाती है और किस तरह से एक character में this is also much required.
Yeah, it's part of training also, meditation, breath control, voice control. Yeah, all these are parts of being training as an actor.
This baritone which you have is because of the voice modulation which you are able to do. In fact, Terence was yesterday really appreciative of that and say he has such a good baritone aur wo Amitabh Bachchan ki awaaz mein bhi bol sakte hain aur is tarah se to ye aap kya ye breathing exercises
was Terence talking about me?
Yeah, he spoke, you saw, see yesterday's webinar which we did, so because he was mentioning that tomorrow we are going to be having you, so it was that time when he was talking about
if somebody as multi talented as Terence says it, I'm going to take it as a compliment, but I guess it's also because of the amount of theater that I've done. My voice has been cultured. The amount of work that I've done on radio earlier, jab hum Yuvani karte the, Akashvani aur Vivid Bharati ke liye, as students, the amount of work that I've done, and I guess various formats of theater. And secondly, also because my parents had great voices, and even my brother's got a great voice. He, although he does not in front of the camera. So we have this family. There's a family trait of having decent voices, and I've been working on my voice. I try to work on my voice because I try to play with the accents, and because I love doing voiceover acting also. I do a lot of dubbing for foreign films, and so it's also aapki ek, matlab this is my internal or my jisko main apna homework samajhta hu ki main isko karta rehta hu, ek riyaz, because singer to riyaz karta hi hai, dancer bhi riyaz karta hai, painter is constantly painting, to actor ke liye ye sari cheeze ek riyaz. और ये रियाज आपको इट शुड हैपन सबकॉन्शियसली, ये नहीं क्यों नहीं भैया मेरा रियाज का टाइम, ये बिकॉज एक्टर्स बिजनेस इज टू डू दिस अलोंग विद ऑब्जर्विंग, तो ऑब्जर्वेशन एज वेल एज वर्किंग ऑन योरसेल्फ इज समथिंग दैट एन एक्टर नीड्स टू डू, एंड आई हैव बीन एट इट. आई जस्ट होप दैट द वॉइस स्टेज्स, आई मीन द वॉइस स्टेज्स विद मी टिल द डाइंग डे, लेट्स सी.
The task too. In fact, what you spoke about observation, actor, you pick up certain characters. And I think actors, as you said, that they have a photographic memory. At the same time, even the observation is so sharp कि किसी भी सड़क के ऊपर भी चलते हुए आदमी का आप character अपने आप में उतार लेते हैं. So that is so much required.
हाँ मैं देखिए तो ये होता है कि कितनी बार किसी से लड़ाई हो रही होती है या कोई मैं देख रहा था, तो मैं कितनी बार मैं अपनी वाइफ को भी बोलता हूँ, मैं भाई को कि यार ये कैरेक्टर करना, ये कमाल कैरेक्टर है यार, इसको देखते रहना है ना,
कहीं ना कहीं नहीं. और कभी कभी किसी को जैसे आप मिले हैं और आपने जैसे आपको स्क्रिप्ट दी तो आपको लगा कि हाँ उस तरह से मैं कर सकता हूँ, so you've spoken to your director कि मैं ऐसे करता हूँ.
Of course, that is very important. आप उसके कुछ ट्रेंड लेके उसके आप अपना उसमें डालते हैं और फिर आप चार्ट परोसते हैं. इट्स एक्चुअली अ चार्ट, प्रॉपर ग्लोरिफाइड चार्ट. अच्छा यहाँ से लिया फिर अपना डाला, जो आपका तड़का है, जो आपकी चटनी है, जो आपके अदरक के छिले हैं, वो आपका है, बाकी का जिंदगी से लिया हुआ.
तो डायरेक्टर्स एक्टर भी हो पर अपना भी काफी डालना पड़ता है. आई मीन यू हैव टू, करेक्ट करेक्ट करेक्ट,
एब्सोल्युटली एब्सोल्युटली.
सो रोशनी, एनी क्वेश्चंस? वी हैव अ लॉट मेनी क्वेश्चंस व्हिच वी आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम द ऑडियंस आल्सो. वुड यू लाइक टू आस्क एनी क्वेश्चन रोशनी?
यस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू मेंशन सर, it has always been great listening to you. Your guidance and your support has always helped MESC team to perform better every day. And we are blessed to have you as your governing council member, as our governing council member. And I would say there's a force behind our success. And I'm excited to mention that we have had over 3,500 plus registration for this webinar and thousands of students are learning from your experience. And now I wish to take 3-4 questions from the participants and request your kind permission.
Sure, please, anytime.
So we have Mahesh. He's saying, "Dear sir, I'm Mahesh Naidu. I'm not that attractive looking because of my complexion and weight. Can I still try career in acting?"
I'm just answering what Vimiji just asked me. See, please understand that gone are the days when the definition of the hero or the heroine was good looking, Greek gods, Charles Atlas. No. The definition has changed. I'm not going to be derogatory, but an actor who was not conventionally good-looking like Om Puri became a Hollywood star. Irfan Khan, the late Irfan Khan, very close to us, was not conventionally good-looking. He wasn't fair. Didn't have a great complexion. Didn't even have a great voice. And in fact, had a voice which was a disadvantage in the start and became his trademark. You look at the great Hollywood actors, okay? Look at this. There's a bald actor called Danny DeVito. Look at Saurabh Shukla over here. Okay. Look at Anu Kapoor Saab. Look at Pankaj Kapoor. Mammootty and Mohanlal are not conventionally good looking. Okay. So the point is that you need to have talent. You need to have screen presence. You need to be intelligent and observant. If you have the skills and the crafts and your tools, irrespective of how you look, because there are roles for every part today. And with the world converging into the digital space, when foreign units are coming to India, Indian units are going abroad, every big web platform and social media platform, television platform, cinema platform is doing casting from India. We are going abroad to shoot. I had also thought when I started off, I had a whole flock of hair. I was the conventional, so-called good-looking Punjabi boy, but a trained actor. Which it took me a long time to tell people I'm not just this chocolate boy, I'm a trained actor. And the day I shaved my hair off in 2007, the kind of work that I've done, I think I'm playing my second innings after that, because that's when people said, I said, "Ye sab nikal ke, I don't want my baggages, I don't want to look conventionally good looking, I just want to be recognized for my talent, for my craft." So Mahesh, if you have it in you, you're willing to learn, willing to be patient, I don't think your look should be a deterrent or should hamper you in any way to get into this trade. But your passion, your zeal, and your self-analysis is very, very, very important.
So we have another question from Hitesh. "I'm a lightning artist in Bhopal, but have always wanted to be an actor. How do I get into the entertainment industry?"
You're a lightning artist? I really don't understand what that means. So does he do lights for sets? That's what I'm not clear.
That's not really mentioned, but yeah.
He says I'm a lightning
artist.
Yeah, so if he, so that he could possibly that he handles light lights on stage, and if he's handled lights on stage, which means he has basic knowledge of stagecraft. Bhopal is one of the premier centers of great theater in the country. You have the Madhya Pradesh School of Drama. You've got the Rangmandal there. You've got Alok Chatterjee's group over there. You've got Rajiv Verma, who does a lot of theater there. Bhopal has produced some great actors. And because it has a very long history of theater, of arts, of painting, of culture, of literature. Bashir Badr Sahab was from Bhopal. You can start doing theatre and workshops with any of the renowned people in Bhopal, like people like Sanjay Mehta and Alok Chatterjee, and get a self-analysis ke light booth se nikal ke jab main stage pe aaunga, kya main ye line bol paunga, kya mere andar wo confidence hai, kya mujhe lagta hai ki ye lighting booth ke confines jahan pe main bahut surakshit hu, wahan se nikal ke kya main border pe ja raha hu, Kargil pe ja raha hu, jo stage hai jahan par dushman yani ke darshak ek tarah se आपको स्क्रूटनी कर रहे हैं, आपका डायरेक्टर आपको स्क्रूटनी कर रहा है, क्या मेरे अंदर वो क्षमता है, क्या अगर मैं नहीं करूंगा तो मेरी जिंदगी असफल रहेगी, अधूरी रहेगी, अगर वो है तो करो. सो द पॉइंट इज दैट ऑल ऑफ अस व्हेन वी डू थिएटर व्हेन वी स्टार्टेड ऑफ ऑल ऑफ अस हैव डन लाइटिंग. सम ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट एक्टर्स ऑन स्टेज हैव बीन ग्रेट लाइट डिजाइनर्स व्हेन दे वर ऑन स्टेज व्हेन वी वर पार्ट ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग पीपल फ्रॉम द एनएसडी एंड पीपल फ्रॉम the Department of Indian Theatre, Chandigarh. So, light and doing lighting, handling sound, props, costumes, makeup, backstage is part of theatre training. So, I don't think that should deter you. It's a step forward, and it also will help you understand. करूं कि ना करूं, और अगर हाँ करूं तो आपकी जो शॉर्टकमिंग्स, आपको अपनी खामियां खुद पता चल जाएंगी. अपनी खामियों को खुद ही समझना, अंडरस्टैंड करना, ये एक कलाकार के लिए बहुत जरूरी है. और अगर आप उसको ओवरकम कर सकते हैं, ठीक. और अगर लगता है कि नहीं, ये मेरे से नहीं हो पाएगा, और ये भी नहीं हो पाएगा, ये आप अपने आप सोचिए, किसी और का ओपिनियन मत लीजिए, अपने आप सोचिए. लेकिन देयर इज, यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम. लाइट बूथ तो ऊपर होता है, कलाकार नीचे होता है. तो आप डेफिनेटली नीचे आके कलाकार के नजरिए से देखिए, दुनिया अलग लगती है.
So, so we have another question from so Jaipal here. I think many of like million viewers would like to know the answer of this question. So Jaipal here, sir, I have been creating viral videos for TikTok, and they are like very much by my friends. What possibility do you suggest that I have to start earning from these short videos?
TikTok definitely has a revenue model, like YouTube also has got a revenue model. Honestly speaking, if anybody is making great money out of YouTube, TikTok, being social influencers on Instagram or on Facebook or on Twitter, I have nothing against it. I am here to talk about this serious craft called acting. Your training in acting, your performance, your understanding will even help you to generate more traffic on TikTok or on IGTV or any of these videos, because you will have your skills intact. What is the revenue model you're thinking of? How you're going to get co-brands is something that you need to decide. If you feel that you and your friends getting together, or your colleagues getting together, or some brand that you're trying to promote on TikTok, you want to do something of this sort, or do something on Instagram, entirely your call. But please understand that that trained actors, when they do stuff on social media, on the digital, they definitely, it's much more professional. That's why you have people like Sumer Pasricha and people like Gaurav Gera and Bhuvan Bam, and these are the people who are actually trained also in a certain level. Gaurav is a proper trained actor. Sumer Pasricha is a proper trained actor. So these people are trained actors who have other skill sets also, and now they've become digital sensations, social media sensations, because unki kya thi ki aapka at least base level tayari to aapki hai, because yes, it's social media and the digital generation has given us a lot of opportunities, but it's also giving us a lot of crap. Yeah. Now, yeah. So the point is that if you want to enter into the serious domain where the serious stakeholders want to look at you seriously as a serious performer, then you need to be very clear what kind of TikTok stuff are you doing also. Okay. So, and I don't want to take names. There are takers for all kind of content on social media, but the takers for this content are not the serious takers.
And I think I also agree with you. You know, COVID ke time par ghar mein baithe hue TikTok karke as a hobby, as a pastime, it is good. But if you want to enter actually acting, it's a serious profession which people need to understand. Aur wo jaise humne kaha, ek tapasya hai. So iske liye aapko puri mehnat karni padegi. You don't get it without
absolutely. Absolutely. Absolutely.
So, thanks a lot, sir. There are like over 300 questions, but we all know it could not be answered live. So, we'll share with you some selected ones. Okay. And request your suggestion. With that, I thank you from my side and on behalf of my participant. And I'm sure audience is really learning a lot, like Vimi. So, there's one compliment which I would like to mention, sir. So, Swati from Delhi. Sir, aapki awaaz bahut zabardast hai. It connects directly from inside. Thank you for such a wonderful session.
Abhi, khud ki awaaz itni achhi hai, jab unhone tareef ki hai, toh I will take this as a compliment. Aur I think kai baar, kyunki meri awaaz itni strong hai, toh mujhe kai baar kuch soft roles nahi bhi mile. Iska ek disadvantage bhi hua hai. So, many a time when I have to do a soft role and something which is तो वो आई हैव टू यू नो प्ले विद माय वॉइस टू मॉडिफाई इट टू नलिफाई द बेस वो करना पड़ता है बट मैं जो लोग मुझे जानते हैं और जो लोग इस पूरी इंडस्ट्री में ये जानते हैं कि वन क्वालिफिकेशन या डिसक्वालिफिकेशन कि मैं जो भी करता हूँ मैं दिल से करता हूँ और आई थिंक दैट इज व्हाई आई एम एबल टू ऑनेस्टली पोर्ट्रे एवरी कैरेक्टर मैं अपने फन के साथ या अपने रोजी रोटी के साथ मैं कभी भी खिलवाड़ नहीं करता और मुझे लगता है कि क्योंकि मैं ऑनेस्ट रहा हूँ इसीलिए इंडस्ट्री मेरे साथ ऑनेस्ट रही है लेवल ऑफ अचीवमेंट ऑफ सक्सेस एंड फेलियर इज आई लीव इट टू गॉड एंड आई लीव इट टू फेट बट whatever I've achieved and whatever the industry has given me is just because of their sincerity and my sincerity. That's it. But thank you so much for the call.
So, thanks a lot, sir. So, Bimmi ji, over to you.
Yeah, thank you, Roshni. And I, as I can see, there are so many questions and most of the people have actually asked that how do they enter into the acting field? How do you prepare yourself? Portfolio banane ki zarurat hai? How does theater actually help? I think we've covered most of them. For aur bhi koi questions, so you can send us and we'll extend it. Please send it on our MESC website on Vidyadan platform and we'll take it with Sahil and get back to you. And so I also, sir, wanted to ask you that you are the joint secretary of Cinta. So especially for the cine artists, for the TV artists in this COVID period, where you know people are feeling ki pata nahi kab khulega, when will we get back to normal, the same kind of work will be there, the same kind of platforms will be there. So iske bare mein, if you, your views on this.
Mimi, we are standing at a time when the opportunity for any aspiring or any actor who's already in the trade, we were at the peak of our opportunities because we've got live performances, we've got anchoring, people who are master of ceremonies, there are RJs, there are VJs, there are TV presenters, sports presenters, film actors, TV actors, web actors, internet sensations, people who are stars on social media, YouTube sensations. So we're talking about 30, 35, 40 areas where of job opportunities were available. Voiceovers, dubbing, okay, different language dubbing, Hindi English dubbing, voicing for ads, acting in ad films, documentaries, short films, anchoring of corporate films. Suddenly all this business has come to a stall. So as Cinta is India's oldest association of actors, and we've, as the senior joint secretary and as the chairperson of the outreach committee, it becomes my responsibility and our committee's responsibility to look after the 10,000 plus actors that we have in the region of Western India, primarily people working in the Hindi and related mediums, and also our tie-up with all the other related acting associations in the country. So when COVID hit us, individually as an actor, of course, I have 5 projects which are in the completion stage, so they've all gone for a toss. When they'll happen, we don't know. We have about 5,000 members who are below the poverty line because they're people who work about 3 days, 4 days, 5 days a month. You know, would get one voiceover job, one dubbing job, one episode of Savdhan India or Crime Alert or Crime Patrol or some cameo in a historical or some walk-in parts. They are trained actors. There are members. So what, once the lockdown was announced, we made a plea. We've managed to provide in phases, 2,000 rupees, then 3,000 rupees, then 2,000 rupees. And then, of course, Mr. Bachchan and Kalyan Jewelers and Sony, they gave Big Bazaar coupons. Being Human Foundation helped us out. Hrithik Roshan helped us out. Vidya Balan helped us out. A lot of PV actors helped us out. Farhan Akhtar helped us out. Shabana Ji helped us out. Diya Mirza helped us out. So all this, we started. We have another sister concern, which is the trust, which is Cine Artists Welfare Trust, with people like Hema Ji and Johnny Lever, Lip Kumar Saab. They're in the trust. So we, Cinta and the CAWT collectively tried to do a lot of, whatever funding. And now we're also, because Maharashtra is where most of the actors stay because of people not, you know, they should not get stressed because of the landlords trying to pressurize them to give their rent. So we have an outreach program wherein each actor in Mumbai is connected to 10 of his actors in his zone. We've called it the zonal outreach program. So, which we've got, we've tried to use the multi-level marketing kind of a format. So every actor staying in his or her area is directly connected on a one-to-one with 10 of his other actors. So that there is any time the financial need, emotional need, physical need, stress, medical, anything, we are there for each other, because Mumbai or any metropolis can get to be lonely. As actors, we are sensitive. A lot of us have come in from different cities. Unfortunately, a lot of our people have anyway gone back to their hometowns, not knowing when the lockout is going to happen. But we've tried to make the best use of this lockout by encouraging people to, like, for example, this webinar is a great thing for me, because I, as an actor, I'm also getting de-stressed by talking to people. Also trying to say that, yes, there is a light at the end of the tunnel. Things will come back. People are doing innovative videos on social media. I mean, there are big actors who are, you know, trying to edit. And then you have DOPs coming on the side. You've also got skeletal shoots happening. See, the COVID, we'll know that we might have to live with it, as was what the doctors say. We might have to live with it. We'll have to get into herd immunity. As Indians, we're very lucky because our immune systems are strong. In spite of such a large population, and when they say that we have reached just after China or in terms of COVID cases, you can't compare, because our sanitation and climatic standards are not the same when it comes to the Western world. But aren't we glad that we aren't in America right now?
Exactly.
You know, yeah, because right now as I'm talking to you, I was supposed to be shooting a series for HBO in LA. I'm just glad that I'm here, because if I was stuck over there in the time of a pandemic there, it would have been crazy. As Cinta, we've done a bit. We are again starting with our second round of funding. We've started another Kunal Kapoor, the actor, if you know him from Rang De Basanti. And so Kunal Kapoor has an NGO which is called keto.org. We've appealed for funds there. A lot of people, a lot of different stakeholders have come forward. We are hoping to get some funds from Netflix. The Federation of Western India Cine Employees, Cinta, and all the producers and the stakeholders and the broadcasters are getting together to decide SOPs, which is standard operating procedures. How do we resume shooting? What is going to be the health guidelines, the insurance guidelines, the intimacy guidelines, the virologist on the set? All this is because we need to start. The M&E also industry are also the faces of every campaign that the country does. So the point is that even if tomorrow a campaign regarding COVID has to be sent across to the mass, to the masses, you need a face of an actor, you need a DOP to create the campaign. Like Akshay Kumar does the anti-smoking campaign, or Rahul Dravid does something. Even if you've got to promote the IPL or the World T20 or the Olympics, you need media faces. You need people like all of you all who are listening, or aspirants, people like us and other people who are. So we're trying to work out a mechanism in which we come out strong and take this lockdown period to understand what are the various formats that you can attack post the removal of lockdown, so that you know that this is the buffet and these are the dishes that I want to pick, or these are the dishes I want to attack. I'm putting it in a very broad perspective.
Thank you so much for sharing that also with us. And it's so heartening to see that puri family ek parivar hai. Parivar ke upar samasya aayi hai, to sabhi log uske saath khade hain.
Correct. Because jab bhi Bharat war jung pe gaya tha, to it's always been the actors, the directors who've always gone ahead and collected funds. And I remember Sunil Dutt saab, Nargis ji, Prithviraj Kapoor, they've all gone to the front and collected funds, gone to people, gana, bajana. So wo, hum bhi karenge ye, ek bar lockdown remove ho gaya, for everybody, for funds, not only for our industry, for the entire country. We will do this and hope we can, distribute it to wherever. Matlab, hamara to bhala hoga hi, because at least we get some, because none of us in the industry, even from the lowest common denominator to the highest common denominator, has earned a single penny for the last 2 months. So these are tough times world over. And I think we will tide over the fact, because kehte hain na ki himmat hai marda madad hai khuda.
आपके साथ इतनी बातें कर सकती हूँ, क्योंकि इतना कुछ सीखने को मिल रहा है, आई एम श्योर इट गोज फॉर द ऑडियंस ऑल्सो, पर समय की पाबंदी है, तो एक रैपिड फायर राउंड हो जाए. तो विच इज योर हैज बीन योर बेस्ट रोल एज एन एक्टर?
I think it's still to come, but I've definitely enjoyed playing Aurangzeb in Swaraj Rakshak Sambhaji. It was a dream come true to play one of history's biggest villains and a man who had so much conviction in his black deeds. So it was very, very exciting, and I garnered a lot of love and hate at the same time for it. So yeah, but I think the best role is still to come.
So you say it's still to come, so which is your dream role?
I'd really love to play a very, very dark character, because, very dark character with not the essential typical villain, but a dark character with a dark past, with you know, psychological crumbles in his mind, and not actually a criminal, because criminals also believe that what they do is right. I'm looking for, because there is, this world today has got a lot of dark facets to all our personalities if we try to hide. I want to do a character which is, could be on the lines of the Joker, or you know, which he or she tries to you know, portray his darkness through positivity. That is something I'm looking at. A complex character, simple characters, both kar liye.
And simple, bahut kar liye. So toughest role which you felt as an actor till now?
Toughest was, I think, each and every episode of Upanishad Ganga, which I did with Dr. Chandraprakash Dwivedi, because unki script aisi thi, because the Chinmaya Foundation, Mahindra Foundation, Doordarshan and Dr. Chandraprakash. So 52 episode mein 52 alag character jo abhi Doordarshan pe wapas dikha rahe hain, jiske DVDs aapko shimaru pe milte hain. 52 episode mein shudh hindi, alag getup, alag character, alag premise. That was the toughest, because har roz aisa lagta tha ki main jung pe ja raha hu ya exam ke liye ja raha hu. And people who can see Upanishad Ganga, you will know what I'm talking about. One of the, it's that those 6-7 months of shooting was tough, because every night I'd be running with the lines, every morning with the character, aur 4 din ke baad aap kuch aur kar rahe. So wo aisa laga tha ki main engineering, MBA, MBBS, MD aur acting ki pariksha ek saath de raha hu. And it was tough, and I'm glad I was safe and sound. Nikala hai.
Achha, your favorite movie? Jisme thi ki aapne acting na ki ho, but any movie which you admire and you want ki kabhi mujhe us tarah ka kirdar karne ko
bhi mile. I think among the Hindi films, I would say Jaane Bhi Do Yaaro, because
Jaane Bhi Do Yaaro.
Every time I see it, I just laugh.
Aur usme kiska character?
Oh, I would love to play the role that Satish Shah played.
Yeah, okay.
Because, and he was so good. He was so good because ek to half the time
you
he
know,
was
as dead a body. Dead body, he was also very good.
Outstanding. And the scenes before that, because I mean, I'm a great fan of Satish Shah. He's a great friend of ours also. But I loved the, I mean, any, actually, Jaane Bhi Do Yaaro jaisa ensemble film mile, I'd love to play any character. I mean, I'd loved what Nasiruddin Shah had also done. I'd loved what Deepak Kadar had done, what Pankaj Bhai had done. I think because in logon ko dekhkar to hum line mein aaye hain. So, and I think the character that Om Puri did, so Jaane Bhi Do Yaaro was a cult classic for me in Hindi. I also would like to play, if I can get the opportunity, to do what Balraj Sahni did in Kabuliwala. Okay, so that was something that is also very, very, very... It's, and what... Kamal Hassan Saab did in Mani Ratnam's film Nayakan. So I'd like to play, I mean, it's a very dream role to play a very, very passionate underworld don is what I'm looking, a mafia so, but with a okay. With passion, you know.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm sure a lot many people are listening. Aur aapka koi favorite song?
Oh, it's my all time is Zindagi ke safar mein guzar jaate hain, makam wo phir nahi aate. So it's something that I keep on humming to myself all the time.
So with your deep baritone, koi ek aapka favorite dialogue?
Dialogue mera khud ka nahi hai, but I something that I always think hai. Rajesh Khanna sahab ka dialogue tha Anand mein, ke babu mushay ye duniya ek rangmanch hai, babu mushay ye duniya ek rangmanch hai, aur hum sab kathputli hai jinki door upar wale ke haath mein bandi. This is something that I always think that it's, we are mere pawns in the arms of the Almighty. I always remember this, and I think this is my favorite line. Aur ye tha ke, it's a beautiful line, and two great actors, Rajesh Khanna and Amitabh Bachchan, in the same frame. And so, matlab, these were inspirations that grew up. So,
and you know, I think this dialogue says it all. Yadi hum log ye samajh jaye ki hamari door upar wale ke haath mein hai. We as just a small speck in this universe, and we think we are all powerful and all knowledgeable. And that is where this COVID has also taught us a lot of lesson. Ek virus bhi tumhe kya bana sakta hai.
Jaise main Gulzar sahab ka ek play karta hu Paasa, usme yaksh Yudhishthir se poochta hai ki gurur kya hai. To main kehta hu ki gurur hai yaksh, insaan ki nadani hai. सबकी डोरियां बाजीगर ने अपनी उंगली से बांधी है, जिसे बाजीगर को लगता है वो उसकी अपनी कोशिश है, वो ऊपर वाले की एक उंगली की जुम्बिश, विच मीन्स वी स्टिल हम किस अहंकार में जी रहे हैं, और वी हैव नॉट बीन एबल टू डिसाइड कि सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट और अहंकार में क्या फर्क है. जिस दिन ये रियलाइज कर लेंगे, आई थिंक द वर्ल्ड विल बी अ बेटर प्लेस.
Thank you so very much. It's been so lovely talking to you.
Thank
and
you.
Learning from your journey and such beautiful thoughts you have. So inspiring, so motivating. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for that.
And in fact, before we leave, we would also like to tell our viewers that our next webinar is on the 18th, 11:30, where we are going to be joined by Mr. Anurag Sharma. And we're going to be looking into the career opportunities in the world of television. और आज हमने एक्टिंग की, और वैसे भी टेलीविजन पर भी काफ़ी बहुत सारी स्ट्रीम्स हैं, उसके बारे में जानेंगे. यू कैन सी इट ऑन द स्क्रीन्स नाउ. एक्सक्लूसिव वेबिनार ऑन करियर अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन टेलीविजन. अनुराग शर्मा, द इंडियन टेलीविजन एक्टर, इज गोइंग टू बी जॉइनिंग अस. वी ऑल्सो हैव, दिस इज ऑन मंडे. ऑन ट्यूजडे वी हैव मिस मेघा भई इज गोइंग टू बी जॉइनिंग अस अलॉन्ग विद मिस्टर चैतन्य फ्रॉम विस्लिंग वुड्स. And that's again, you can see on the screen. So, 19 तारीख को भी 11:30 बजे हमारा वेबिनार होगा. उससे पहले 18 तारीख को मंडे को 11:30 बजे where we have Anurag Sharma who's going to be joining us. और आज के जो वेबिनार में, I hope you've taken the selfies. Please upload it on the social media. Tag us also. Tag MESE, tag Vidyadan. अपना फीडबैक भी साथ साथ हमें भेजते रहें. कोई आपकी रिकमेंडेशंस है, सजेशंस है, कुछ और आप कोई मीडिया एंटरटेनमेंट फील्ड में ही किसी एक पर्टिकुलर स्ट्रीम के बारे में और जानकारी लेना चाहते हैं, यू कैन ऑलवेज लेट अस नो एंड वील ट्राई हैविंग अ वेबिनार ऑन दैट ऑल्सो. सो विद दैट इट्स अ रैप फ्रॉम माय साइड. इट वाज वंस अगेन थैंकिंग मिस्टर बहल फॉर जॉइनिंग अस एंड ऑल ऑफ यू एट होम. इट्स आजकल वैसे वीकेंड पता नहीं चलता कब सैटरडे आया कब संडे आ गया, बट एनी वेज इट्स वीकेंड स्टार्टेड. सो एंजॉय दिस एंड स्टे हैप्पी, स्टे हेल्दी एंड बी विद योर फैमिली. और हर मोमेंट को जियो और इस मोमेंट को एंजॉय करो. विद दैट बाय, टेक केयर.
थैंक यू.